Dyslexic teachers, educated fools. What did they tell you about freedom when justice was saying that you are just a pro bono case and it's you against the state and the first right you have is to remain silent. Everything you say will be used against you in the court of law. City rascals, village fools. What are they telling you about the hand of greed between pickpocketing and stealing country? I'm going to hit you with a string of short poems, and then I'm going to do a lengthy one as well. Yeah? Right? Just a warning, I'm not sure poems are anything that I will see happen before you want them to. So let me just get that out of the way. How? Just know what it is. It's just a struggle, and then it's like, yeah, that's it. Like, this will be the message of it. The first one I want to do is called 28, because I'm 28. That's deep. Right, it goes, I am a tax-numbered cynic who believes that justice scale is always tilting. I am a tax-numbered cynic who believes that justice scale is always tilting. Yet I am baffled by the novelty of fully grown men and starving offsprings. The hypocrisy of people's moral pedestal, but they can't stand to reach for it. And the misogyny of men who wrote the laws, but then forgot the testicles are sensitive. Yes. The second one is called Medusa, as in like the Greek goddess, one more than it. Shout me out from the top of your voice. Armor your tone with thorns. Your words are specks. You chisel me carelessly, how you spit me into shreds. How you command me to submit to your regressive movements. Fill the ambience with the clatters of your ego. You are such a romantic. You tie a noose of insult around my neck. Your pleasure is to watch me choke on them. You look at me like a canvas with all your shortcomings splattered all over it. Men, you simple creatures of simple habit. Oh, you sons who peed on your mother's gardens and got away with it. You have been exhuming women's bodies for centuries, searching for your mother's life. Another short one, just between two lines. It goes, a soldier in arms with all his prayers loaded on his fingertip, pointing his artillery at the supposed enemy who prayed to the same God for the same victory. God's humor. Right, so the last one is nothing to do with the air. Yes, he's going to help you with that. So, but my father, it's called collecting dust. reminisce like a well-traveled storyteller. His stories were wrinkles between the wrinkles of his time. Stories of suffering yearning for solitude. Stories of reason longing for truth. Stories of everything that he stood for and all that broke him. How his words would often hang something heavy. How he would casually make jokes about death as if he's resuscitating a room full of dying people. His honesty was too blunt to speak the least of. An ashy voice, a rusty cough, a vintage heart, it sounded like a boombox for a beat. A bundle of wires for a beard. An armor for shoulders that hung his towering skeleton. My father was a simple man. And never have I seen anyone adjust so well to the piling weight of his grudge just so long as he keeps it. So what gives in this world to men with beaten souls and bended backs sheltered by a falling home? I blame my grandmother. She was tough as nails on coffined secrets. On her deathbed, she laid refusing my father's redemption. And so I grew to watch how he rocks himself to sleep, tossing between his worries, displeased with the withers of time like a peeling antique. And I realized that the death of a parent can make ghost towns out of the living. That for some time our chest can become abandoned buildings. We have all scraped our childhood floors searching for our lost innocence. My father's sole purpose was learning forgiveness. My mother taught me not to use the word broken so often. Some things are not as bad as they seem. Some men have learned to walk as they bleed. You have known your men, your father as a man who treads midnight to their fall. Do not ask him to bear the logic for the blisters under his feet. For you know of journeys traveled by men who hold the sunset, the sunrise at gunpoint.